जवाहर नवोदय विद्यालय शंकर नगर डिस्ट्रिक्ट नांदेड वेलकम्स यू ऑल। Dear students, we are going to continue the second lesson titled as A Lost Spring from the Flamingo textbook of our class 12. Today we are going to take up the second part, that means the second story of this particular lesson, A Lost Spring, subtitled as Stories of a Stolen Childhood. Dear students, so this lesson is going to deal with the issue of a child labor, and as it is often referred as a work that deprives the children of their childhood, their potential and their dignity, and that is a harmful to physical as well as mental development of a child. And that is what the prime concern of writer Anish Jung in this lesson. The second story, titled as I Want to Drive a Car. So in this particular story, we are going to come across a boy, a Mukesh, who belongs to a bangle making family, and the narrator is going to tell us the story of Mukesh, at the same time going to throw light upon the bangle making community or the caste of a particular town called Firozabad. In this story, we are going to come across a boy named as Mukesh, and that boy insisted to be his own master. The protagonist Mukesh wants to be a car driver, and in order to become a car driver, first of all he wants to become a motor mechanic, and he had a plan also, and he will learn how to drive a car, and after that he thought of becoming a car driver. But whatever the dream he has, that looks like a mirage. Here in this story, the narrator is going to tell us about a Mukesh, a boy. This boy, he is from Firozabad glassmaking industry, and as a family tradition that each and every members of the families are engaged in making bangles, and because of that Mukesh also become a child labor. But this boy is a daring and different from other young children of Firozabad, who have submitted the age-old miseries and traditional. The narrator visited a Firozabad. Firozabad is famous for its bangle making industry, and this particular place called Firozabad is also called as the city of bangles. Almost every other family in Firozabad is engaged in making a glass bangles for a woman all over India. Glass bangles of Firozabad are very popular and famous. They are a symbol of a woman's marital status in our country. Dear students, look at this map, and this is a map of Firozabad. Firozabad is a small industrial town located nearly 200 kilometers away from our national capital, New Delhi. And even it is very near to the Agra, Mathura, Hathras, Etah and Mainpuri. So this particular place called Firozabad is known for its glass industry, and particularly it's famous for bangles. Firozabad has been producing glass bangles for more than 200 years now, and it is the biggest manufacturer of glass bangles in the world. Bangle making is a household business with a traditional technique being passed on through generation. But a bangle industry in Firozabad, the cruel darkness behind the vibrant views. So as bangle is a type of ornament worn mostly by South Indian women in a different style. It is the most famous in India, Pakistan and Sri Lanka, and even it is worn in Bangladesh too. Firozabad in Uttar Pradesh is the largest producer of glass bangles in the world. But the story behind this glittering bangle is something different. Now, let me carry you to the city of bangles, Firozabad.
बैंगल्स के बाद यहाँ ग्लास शुरू हुआ है। पहले यहाँ से फिरोजाबाद सिर्फ सेल करने के लिए आया करती थी बैंगल।
अरे पिताजी करते थे पहले ये काम। पिताजी के एक्सपायर होने के बाद में ये काम हमने किया है।
हमारे बाप दादा और बाप दादे काफी अरसे चल रहा है इस बड़ी काम तो।
साल
साल
की
जब
तो
आदत
करते
हैं।
पहले डर लगता था
हमने
लगता।
आज हमको कम से कम ये समझ लो आज हमें काम इस गर्म काम में घुसे हुए आज कम से कम हमें 35 साल करीब हो गए।
तो प्रॉब्लम तो होता ही है थोड़ा सा गर्मी है उस वजह से।
सेफ्टी के लिए यहाँ कुछ भी नहीं है। सेफ्टी के लिए अगर हाथ कट भी जाता है तो ये सुतलियाँ हैं, सुतलियाँ इनको निकाल लीजिए और यूं करके बांध लीजिए। खून रुक जाएगा कुछ देर के लिए फिर फेंक दीजिए। यही पट्टी है यहाँ पर।
वो
यहाँ तो जलते ही रहते हैं, जलना ही काम है। ये काम ऐसा है कि यहाँ कोई किसी का वो नहीं है, आज आ गया कल तो कल दूसरा आ जाएगा, आज मैंने कर लिया कल दूसरा कर गया, परसों कोई और कर गया।
छुट्टी वगैरह पड़ती है, रजिस्टर्ड छुट्टी पड़ती है, त्यौहार वगैरह, इतवार वगैरह, संडे वगैरह, इसके कोई पैसा नहीं मिलता आप लोगों को।
फिफ्टीन आवर्स वर्किंग स्टार्ट हो जाती है। भट्टी में जब कांच मेल्ट हो जाता है तो उसको हम लोग लोहे की लबियों से, बड़ी बड़ी लबियाँ होती हैं, उससे हम लोग निकालते हैं। लौंग बेलन पे जाती है, उसके बाद उसमें चूड़ी बन जाती है, चूड़ी स्प्रिंग टाइप की चूड़ी बन जाती है। कई तरीके के वर्क होते हैं चूड़ी के ऊपर, कुछ जरी का काम करते हैं, कुछ हिल का काम करते हैं, कुछ पॉलिश का काम करते हैं, कुछ लोग ऐसे ही प्लेन भी बेचते हैं, जुड़ने के बाद प्लेन चूड़ी भी बिकती है।
The glittering bangles sold and bought without a thought are a result of the sweat and blood of those bangle making family of Firozabad. So each bangle passes through at least 80 hands before it reaches to the customer's hand. Half of the work is done in the factory, but the other half, which is the most important, is done in a people's homes. So that's why every family member in a Firozabad works on a bangle in their own homes. And that's why there is also a black side of this bangle industry, because most of the children of a family and a city also help their parents in order to prepare the bangle. And that's why the child labor is still used extensively in the Firozabad. A child labor, they said that he works in a bangle making factory for 8 hours and manages to get a meager daily wage, that of nearly 50 to 60 rupees. So as a worker in a glass factory begins his day by 4 early in the morning and ends by 7 p.m. in the evening, so the adults are paid about 80 to 90 rupees for a day hard labor, whereas the children are prepared for a work in the industry as they are paid much lesser than their adult counterparts. The quality checks involves of touching each bangle with a stone and deciphering the sound it makes while it's doing so to ensure that no cracked or a broken bangle manages to reach the final box of packing. The combination of chemicals, heat and glass used in this bangle making industry is a major health hazard for the workers who are associated with this. Child labor and a manpower exploitation is a sad reality, as most of the factory or the household are informally run by the families or individuals who are going to oppress and suppress these people who are engaged with these kinds of work. Even a small children throughout a day, their eyes are totally get adjusted with a fire, and because of that they are going to face a lot of problem in the later stage of their life. Every family in a Firozabad engage in working at a furnaces, welding glass, making bangles for a generation. Firozabad city has about 20,000 children working in a hot furnaces, slogging daylight hours, often losing the brightness of their eyes before they become adults. The bangle makers of Firozabad live a miserable and pathetic life. They work and live in an inhuman condition. There are dark hutments where in the flames of a flickering oil lamp sit a boys and girls wielding pieces of a colored glasses, a little releasing the impacts of such a dim light on their eyes. The conditions are unhygienic and lacking basic amenities, and there is no one to listen to their voice, and that's why the working condition in these glass furnaces are very much dingy and pathetic. These are the problems which the bangle makers are going to face while doing a work in a glass furnaces with a high temperature, and most of their house or huts are a dingy cells without a proper air or a light, and the workers will start facing a problem of losing eyesightness at a very early age due to bad posture or a long working hours. So due to all these reasons, a lot of children who are engaged in the working of a glass making factory, and those children, they start losing their eyesight early in their life, and this is what an unfortunate thing, and there is no one to listen to them, and they have to suffer a lot, and this condition makes them in a very pathetic way. The bangle makers of Firozabad make a beautiful bangles which are worn by women all across our country, but the joy of wearing a bangles is derived at the expense of a labor of millions of working children who are condemned to live a life of abject poverty and exploitation. The bangle makers live and die in poverty. Their homes are just like hovels with a crumbling walls, wobbly doors and no windows, and they have not been able to send their children to a school, and the children help them welding the piece of colored glass into circles of bangles. Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark than to the light outside. If at all they go outside, they may not be able to get adjust themselves. So working in a hot furnaces all throughout the daylight hours, they often end up losing their brightness of their eyes, and for them there is no light even at the end of the tunnel. And these are some health hazards which these people are facing. First one, that is a eyesightedness, that is a common which we can found among those bangle makers. Be it a child, be it a elder, or be it a adult, everyone is facing the problem with the eyesightedness. The second one, that most of them, they have a respiratory problem, because as their the place of working as not having a proper ventilation or fresh air, and that's why they are facing a lot of troubles with their own breathing system. And most of them, they become a patient of cancer and tuberculosis. And all these people, children, those who are working in the bangle making factories or the houses, they are exposed to the deadly chemicals which is going to affect their health later onwards. The narrator visited Firozabad. So as a Mukesh family was engaged in making of bangles, so Mukesh took the narrator to his house. So both narrator and Mukesh went through the stinking lanes chocked with the garbage. A families of a bangle makers lived there, and most of them, they are living in the area which is called as slum. Their houses had a crumbling walls and oobly doors. They entered Mukesh's house, which was like any other house in the lane, and it is half built, and still the Mukesh feels very much proud of his home. And narrator get a glance of half-built house of a Mukesh. Narrator get a first-hand information about a Mukesh house and the living condition of the people who are staying in those tinted lanes of a Firozabad. And Mukesh house, a oobly iron door, a half-built sack, it's in one part attached with a dead grass, a firewood stove over which was placed a large vessel of a sizzling spinach leaves, more chopped vegetables in a large platter was kept over there. And this is what the condition of not only Mukesh, and the same is the story of other houses. So most of the houses are crumbling walls, they don't have at all strong or proper walls. Humans and animals are both together, live together both, and there is no proper drainage system, there is no sewage, there is no proper water facility, and because of that, very foul, stinking smell we may come across in the lane. And the Mukesh house is also built half, and most of the family members are using only one room, which is the kitchen, a living room, or a bedroom as well. So this is what the living condition of those people who are living in a Firozabad. city, and especially this is what the condition of bangle making families. Mukesh's whole family was engaged in making a bangles, and all of them, they are doing a lot of hard work. The narrator and Mukesh, both of them, they entered the house of Mukesh, which was like any other house in that lane. And suddenly, a frail young woman was cooking a meal on that time on a firewood stove. Her eyes were filled with a smoke, and she greeted the narrator with a smile. And she was a wife of Mukesh's elder brother, and she is in charge of the whole family members. She was respected as the daughter-in-law of a family, and as whenever the elders of the house used to come during that time, she was almost covering her face with a veil as a mark of respect. And that was what the tradition they had in their family. Then the Mukesh father also came in. The daughter-in-law covered her face with a veil as the custom demanded, because Mukesh father was the elder, ahead of the family, and he was old and weak. He had lost his eyesight with the dust from polishing glass bangles. He had worked hard all his life, but he could not afford to send his two sons to the school. He could only teach them the art of bangle making. He had built the house but could not repair it. And that is the condition of a Mukesh father, and he only know the legacy, and that legacy to hand over the family profession, that is none other than bangle making. Apart from elder brother, elder brother's wife, father, there is one more elderly person in the family, and that the elderly person is Mukesh's grandmother. Mukesh's grandmother expressed her belief in a destiny. She said that it was their karma that they were born in the bangle makers' community, and it was their destiny to suffer. But no man could change what was already decided by fate. In fact, her belief was shared by all the peoples of Firozabad. So in this way, Mukesh's grandmother felt that whatever that present state in which they are living a life, it is all the result of their karma. And even she may go up to an extent to believe even her husband who become a blind, it is a part and parcel of a destiny. And art making, that is the art of bangle making, is only a God-given lineage, and these bangle makers should not give up that one. Rather, they should continue to keep on doing. In that belief, the Mukesh grandmother was.
Man.
are one of the most important ornament that an Indian woman wears. For a married woman, bangles are considered a significant sign of their suha. And the irony of this story is that though the bangle is a symbol of suha, though the every girl child one day as a bride will wear a bangle, but some people who are spending their days, such as a small kid or a child, a girl child, who don't know the importance of a bangle, even she don't know that one day she may going to get a chance to wear the same bangles and decorate her hand with a henna. And that is what the irony. And even narrator also met another old lady who becomes so old by preparing a bangle, and still the bangles are there on her wrist, and even the saris which she wore, they are in a tattered condition, and that itself tells the condition, the poverty in which they are leading their life. And by working hard in a due course of time, even she may lost her sight in the eyes. And that is what the irony with the people who are engaged, who are spending their day hours in the dingy cell of a Firozabad. The narrator, after getting a first-hand information about the condition of these bangle makers in Firozabad, even he had suggested them to unite together to raise their issues or the problems which they are facing. But the author also said that the bangle makers are caught in a vicious web because they can't be able to unite themselves, because if at all they try to raise their voice, they are hauled up by the police. They are caught in the restless circles of a poverty, a injustice and a greed by the middlemen, sahukars, policemen and bureaucrats. And this is what the vicious circle, and because of this vicious circle, they can't be able to raise their voice, and due to this, they are facing lot of problems in their life itself. The narrator could see the bangles everywhere in the Firozabad, and the place wherever she visited, she had come across it. She saw many boys and girls welding a pieces of a colored glass. Their eyes would get used to a darkness, and they are often going to lose their eyesight before they were adults. At home, their families worked together all day in front of a big furnace with a high temperature, and this led to many children to become a blind before they are going to reach their adulthood. And that is what the children are going to be double victim. First, by the birth, bordered by the stigma of a caste, and the second, a no hope. They have accepted whatever that profession that the family had, their ancestors have, they accepted it as a family occupation. And the third part of their agony is that these children are not at all getting any kind of education, and because of that, there is no unity at all among themselves to raise their voice against the injustice. And these poor bangle makers, they are suppressed, they are oppressed at each and every step of their life, and in this way, they are suffering a lot. And they have accepted their suffering as a result of a karma theory. And there is a little desire to dream in a snubbed in their childhood. And like this is the condition, and generation after generation, these families of a bangle makers have been suffering a lot. The narrator tries a level best to light upon the Indian caste system, which is a complex social structure wherein a social roles like one's profession become a hereditary, resulting in a restricted social mobility and fixed status hierarchies. As we know that the people in general belong to many social categories that could either be achieved, such as one's profession, or inherited, such as one's gender. The consequences of social categorizations are often not only seen in the dynamics of social interaction, but also in the way of a social status is represented. So this is what the reason for those people of a Firozabad, those who are suffering a lot in their life by being a bangle makers community. And that is what the narrator want to highlight, the flight or the condition of a bangle makers to the boy called Mokesh. Mokesh is an ambitious boy as he dares to dream. He is a different and does not want to get into the rut. He wants to break free from the cycles of a bangle making tradition and chalk out a different path for himself. He wants to become a motor mechanic first, and he wants to learn to drive a car, and in this way he thought of driving a car. For that, he is even ready to walk a long way from his home to the garage in order to learn the driving skill. And that is how, and because of this, the Mokesh can able to do something different from others. Though he know that it is highly impossible for the family from which he belong, but still, he is a very practical guy. He doesn't have a dream of aeroplanes, though there are a lot of aeroplanes are flying over the Firozabad, and he want to be down to earth and just want to drive a car. And in order to realize his dream, he thought better to learn first to drive the car. In order to drive the car, he thought to become a motor mechanic. And that's why, instead of doing the bangles, he thought it is better. And every day, now he was walking along to reach the garage and start learning the skill of driving. So in this way, the Mokesh is a boy who is a different compared to that other youths or the guys of the bangle making family. So in this way, the Mokesh is going to be his own master. Finally, a Mokesh who is an ambitious boy, as he dares to dream, and he is a different and does not want to follow the family tradition, and because of that, he wants to become a motor mechanic and to learn a car driving skills. And in this way, Mokesh is a boy who is full of hope and confidence, and with that he can able to reach and he become a car driver after all learning the skill by doing the work of motor mechanic in a garage. With this, we come to the end of the Mokesh story, and both the story of Saheb Alam and Mokesh had given us a lesson, and the lesson is that the childhood of a human life is a full of joy, immense happiness and playfulness. But ironically, these two children who had come across in the story are started doing a work to support themselves and their families, which is the irony of their childhood, and they are not supposed to do. They are supposed to flourish and blossom in their life by enjoying the happiness. Dear students, keep it in mind that child labor is not a fair. They need love and care, and let us give that the care and love that whatever the children deserve, and let them enjoy their life at the fullest extent. Child labor is a global problem which requires a special attention. The country like India, where the local authorities, teachers, employees, parents and children in a child labor free zones work together to get children out of work and bring them into a school. And all these stakeholders are supposed to be convinced that no child should be working and every child should be in school, and we should stop a child labor. And that is what the oath each and every one of should take and make our country free from these child slavery. Dear students, if at all you have any queries or doubts, you may raise it in the comment box or post it in your own class WhatsApp group. Today's online and offline class, which is dealt by myself, that is Rakesh D. Nadkarni, PGT English, Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, Shankar Nagar, District Nanded, Maharashtra. Thank you, the Quint, because we have utilized the video of a Quint in order to show you the Ferozabad bangle making industry. At the same time, I would like to express a gratitude to Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, Pune Regional Office. And I am very much grateful to my own Vidyalaya, Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, Shankar Nagar, District Nanded. And at last, thank you all my dear students. Thank you.